to McConnell. Now back down inside, deflected by the sophomore, Jennifer Ward. But the jumper thrown in. Substitutions now for the Skyhawks. Jennifer Warden into the game along with Taylor Warnham. Carter inside. Oh, nice look, and there's two for Taylor Warnham.
It's a good example of how this different Stonehill team is trying to figure out who they are.
Urgioli had to pick up her dribble. Now McConnell, baseline 10-footer.
Nervous energy out there.
And they both turned the ball over 18 times in their two wins, so something to work on for certain. Oh, nice duck up and under, and there's two for the freshman, Kayla Raymond. Kelsey Shaw back into the game as well. Now Amy McConnell for Springfield. Springfield with an alley. Oh, and a great block again inside by Reuter. Back outside the arc, though. Three ball on the way is good for Amy McConnell.
I think if we look up here, Charlie, and for Stonehill, if they get into halftime, say within 6 points, they'll feel okay about themselves.
Yep.
Because they played okay, but not really great.
Now Raymond shuffles it off inside for Warden for two. Three ball is off the mark. Stonehill just can't throw it in the ocean right now. Oh, nice look that time. Beautiful pass from Warden to Seymour. Madison Seymour's first points of the night. Down the other end. What a block by Raymond on Lux. Bentley's lead is 13. Reuter for Raymond. Now Shaw back down inside. Reuter got two. Reuter now for Santoro. Inside Raymond falling away. Got two.
And the key part was the entry pass was delivered at the right time.
Back to single digits. Lux right back inside, and the block by Reuter out of bounds, and Lux touched it on the way out. Stonehill ball. Urgioli picked up by the freshman Raymond inside. Nice look, though. That was easy for Megan Lewis, who now has 9 points. Skyhawks unable to find their offense and really struggling shooting. 9 seconds to shoot. Madison Seymour. Shot clock down to five. Trying to drive, does, and scores. Good job by Madison Seymour to stay under control. Falcons will wait for the final shot with 9 seconds to go in this third quarter.
And theoretically, Stonehill can follow. They have one to give.
Lux throws it up, won't get it. Follow is up and good. What a follow by Katie Marigioli to end the third quarter. Now Lux with 10 to shoot. McConnell. Steps through and got two.
Yeah, she split two freshmen that time in Bramante and Raymond.
For Seymour and again Bramante. Thought about the three. Warden, nice shovel pass inside, score the basket and the foul for Gabrielle Reuter.
Push Bentley further on the scoreboard.
Lux ran out of room. Rebound of Warden. No, what a beautiful pass inside, and there's two. Gabrielle Reuter running the floor. And let's see if the Falcons take a shot or if they just try to run the clock out.
We'll just run the clock.
And run the
and
clock,
be
and
that
will be our final score. So the Bentley Falcons open up the NE10 portion of their schedule with a 70-54 win over the Skyhawks. The Falcons now 3-0 overall, 1-0 in league play, and the Skyhawks fall to 2-1 overall and winless in their first game in the NE10.
The weekend games, I was really pleasantly surprised at how we looked this weekend in terms of just some team defense and our execution being on the road with a young team. I was really happy with the weekend, but we knew, you know, this is a different ball game. Obviously, a very talented Bentley team, well coached. You know, they defended well. They threw us out of our rhythm early. You know, I think that, you know, it definitely was that. Okay, here's our first league game. It's a big game. It's Bentley rivalry, and you know, I think from the top down, our veterans included, didn't really respond well to, I think, the going down early and a little bit of the pressure that they were facing. So we got a lot to work on. Yeah, it's certainly a challenging first game out of the gate, especially given where we are right now in terms of our youth at the point, and we're definitely playing freshmen, so the kids coming off the bench and getting minutes that got maybe limited minutes last year, that need to step into more prominent roles. This was a challenging first game, but like you said, this league doesn't get easier. Every night you got to come to play, so. We need to understand what our breakdowns were tonight and get better in a hurry. And that's what I said in the locker room. We got to really think about just the fixes. It is what it was tonight. And we certainly didn't help ourselves out tonight. I feel like, when we made that run and we cut the lead a little bit, I just think we got a little impatient, and that's youth. And you can see the flashes of really good play, at both ends. We did some really nice things during the game, but that's the bottom line. It's our inconsistency, and I think individuals being a little bit more consistent about what they're going to bring to us, and then just as a team, we need to be more consistent in terms of just that ability to make the next play important, all those things about just refocusing. And we got caught up a little in, I think, the scoreboard, and that slowed us down a little bit. Kayla is just a phenomenal young player and does things that you certainly can't teach. She just has a great athleticism to her. And, what I love about her is she wants the ball and she wants to score. And tonight was a big night for her, first home game after coming off such a strong weekend against Bentley. So, you could definitely see a little bit of a difference from the Kayla that we saw tonight as opposed to the weekend. But that's okay. That's going to happen. She's going to, I think, as we play these NE10 games, she's going to understand it's definitely going to be a different ball game, especially when you start so strong, I mean, her touches in the paint were 2 and 3 kids coming at her, so... she's going to get that understanding. And that's where I think our patience comes a little bit. And I think, obviously the upper class players can help a lot in that regard in terms of our ability to go side to side. I don't think overall we didn't execute our offense as well to start the game. We were just really just slow cuts and not going side to side. And, you could see, when Bentley scores, we were slowing down instead of, rip it out of the net and go right back at them. But, that comes with the youth right now, and we'll live with that. We just need to focus on getting better. And our rebounding effort, where I think we have some really strong rebounders, I didn't see that consistently tonight, and that really hurt us. We like the bus rides, apparently. But, I liked the fact that we started on the road this weekend, and that was definitely a long trip, and we played 7 o'clock on Friday and noon on Saturday, so that back-to-back and that recovery, definitely going in, I was really nervous about it, but the kids did great. They responded really well, so, home and away. Maybe we'll love away.